Myself Dr. Avinash Trivedi, Professor in Department of Computer Science and Engineering, CIMS, Greater Noida. Today, the topic of discussion is garbage collection. And these are some topics which I will cover. See, Java garbage collection. Why garbage collection is required? See, we are dealing with object-oriented programming, that is Java. And in Java, we create objects and that object takes some memory and which occupies a space. So if we will always create different objects, then our memory will be short. So there is always a concept that we create object, we use it, and once its use is finished, then we destroy that object. In some languages, we create and destroy both. But in Java, we are bothering about only creation. Cleaning or removing of objects of no use will be done by the Java itself. So it is very useful concept. For memory management also, it is playing a very vital role, and garbage collection is done automatically by the programming language Java. Objects are dynamically allocated by using the new operator. So once we create any object using new operator, then what we get? We get object, and that object is used in program, and once that object is of no use, then it must be destroyed. And in C and C++ programming language, in C++ programming language, programmer need to destroy that object, but in Java this is not. In Java, destruction of object from memory is done automatically by the JVM. So garbage collection is part of JVM. When there is no reference to an object, then that object is assumed to be no longer needed and the memory occupied by the object are released. This technique is called garbage collection. So the objects which are not in use will be removed by the JVM, and this process is known as garbage collection. In C++, dynamically allocated objects must be manually released by use of delete operator. Unlike C++, there is no explicit needed to destroy object. This is done by the JVM only. Sorry. So we can see here, we are creating three objects. Say, Muggy, Tiger and Tubby. And what is happening? We are creating three objects, and these names will be used as reference to created objects, and objects are creating in heap. So there are three objects and all three objects have their respective references. So what happens when we write integer I equal new integer 4? So this creates an object 4 and it references present in I reference variable. And once we declare I equal null, it means I is not referring to any object. So that object is not having any reference. So garbage collection will clear this space and object 4 will be removed from the memory. Earlier, object 4 was referred by reference variable I. But once that object 4 is not having any reference, so garbage collector will remove this. In this image also, heap is containing two objects एंड वन ऑब्जेक्ट इज हैविंग इट्स रेफरेंस. सो S1 इज रेफरिंग वन ऑब्जेक्ट बट अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी रेफरेंस. सो इन गार्बेज कलेक्शन प्रोसेस ऑब्जेक्ट हैविंग वैल्यू 3 and 4 विल बी रिमूव्ड. गार्बेज कलेक्शन बी फोर्स्ड एक्सप्लिसिटली? नो, द गार्बेज कलेक्शन कैन नॉट बी फोर्स्ड एक्सप्लिसिटली. वी गेट रिक्वेस्ट JVM फॉर गार्बेज कलेक्शन बाई कॉलिंग सिस्टम डॉट GC मैथड एंड इट कॉल्स जावा गार्बेज कलेक्टर बट इट इज एट द विल ऑफ JVM. And how JVM will perform this, it depends upon that. Advantages of garbage collection. The programmer does not need to worry about dereferencing an object, increasing memory efficiency because garbage collection is helping in removing unwanted reference objects, decreases the chances of memory leak because if space is properly managed and optimized, then chances or doubt of memory leak is very less. And JVM is putting its extra effort for managing this space. So in this figure, we can see your garbage collector is part of JVM. And it is duty of JVM to execute garbage collection process when it is required. So first of all, we need to understand what is happening. When garbage collection plays its role and how it calls the role. And for this, we need to understand it has some mechanism. In this mechanism, in the first step, unreferenced objects are identified and marked as ready for garbage collection. Once that object has not any reference, then those objects are identified. In the second step, marked objects are deleted. When those objects are not having any reference, those are marked, and in second step, those are removed from the memory. Optionally, memory can be compacted after the garbage collector deletes objects, so remaining objects are in a contiguous block at the start of the heap. So, contiguous means compaction process is taking place. That process is a process of operating system, and your memory management is helping in doing. The compaction process makes it easier to allocate memory to new objects sequentially after the block of memory allocated to existing objects. This is again same as operating system does. All of hot spots garbage collectors. Hot spots garbage collectors are very frequent model of JVM. Implements a means generational garbage collector strategy that categorizes object by age. If that object is not being used for longer time, then that objects are eligible for deletion. The rationale behind generational garbage collection is that most of the objects are short-lived and will be ready for garbage collection soon after creation. In generally, this happens. We use object based upon their time stamping. We can understand the heap is divided into three sections: young generation, old generation, permanent generation. It has three parts: Eden S0, S1 as young generation, tenured as old generation, and permanent as third generation. So, depend upon the condition, it looks at whether it is फ्रॉम विच कैटेगरी? हाउ कैन एन ऑब्जेक्ट बी अनरेफरेंस्ड? देर आर मैनी वेज. वन वेरी कॉमन वन इज नलिंग द रेफरेंस, असाइनिंग एस रेफरेंस टू अनदर वन बाई एनोनिमस ऑब्जेक्ट्स, एंड फोर्थ वन इज आइसोलेटिंग अ रेफरेंस. हाउ वी गो फॉर नलिंग अ रेफरेंस? इफ देर इज वन ऑब्जेक्ट दैट इज सी एस विच वी हैव क्रिएटेड, एंड इफ यू मैंशन ऑब्जेक्ट इक्वल नल, इट मीन्स वी आर नलिफाइंग द रेफरेंस एंड दैट इज हेल्पिंग गार्बेज कलेक्टर टू रिमूव. दिस इज वन मैथड ऑफ अनरेफरेंसिंग एनी ऑब्जेक्ट. सो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन प्रोग्राम. सी इन दिस प्रोग्राम देर इज वन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ स्ट्रिंग बफर. greet is created, it is having value hello, and when greet is equal null, it means you are nullifying your object, and that object is free to remove. Second one is assigning a reference to another one. In this slide we can see we are creating two objects, say n1 and n2. And once we write n1 is equal n2, it means n1 is now referring to object which was referred by n2, and now the object which was referenced by n1 is free to remove. Similarly, in second statement, employee p1, p2. Two objects are there. If you're writing p1 equal p2, now the first object referred by p1 is available for garbage collection because that has lost its reference. So this is second one method. We can understand with the help of this program. There is a reference garbage demo, and it has one method main. And we are creating two objects. Greet means two objects, hello and goodbye. And reference variables are greet and greet new. So once we write greet equal greet new, now the object hello is free to remove. And once we get output in system.out.println, we get goodbye. Now hello is free to remove, so we can remove it. Third is anonymous objects. As we know, what is anonymous object? Anonymous object, actually the reference of anonymous objects will not be stored anywhere, therefore after the first execution you cannot call it again, hence it is unreachable. So declaring any object as anonymous, we can easily remove with the help of garbage collector. So in this program also, how we can create any anonymous object? We can create an anonymous object using new and class name. So two objects we are creating here. New class name is acting as anonymous object. Similarly, in this program, in main method, we are creating object directly without mentioning its reference. So new string buffer hello is creating one object, and that object is used only once. So after this use, that object is free to remove. So third very good way of writing or deleting any object, that is declare that object as anonymous object. Fourth one is isolating a reference. You create object and assign it reference as null, and this you are using to make that object as reference free, and garbage collector will look that object and delete. So program this time we are not removing the reference variable, just isolating them. See, in this program what we are doing, we are mentioning all the objects as null referencing, so these objects can be removed. So thanks a lot. We will discuss some other topic in our next slides.